daycare and preschool in the Netherlands. In our previous videos, we have talked about the various stages in the lives of school-aged children. Do you have a child aged 0 to 4? And do you live in or will you be relocating to the Netherlands? Then this video is for you. During the coming roughly 12 minutes, I, Annabeth Vermamer from NewtoNL, will take you by the hand and explain all your childcare options. Daycare, preschool, childminder, also known as gastouder in Dutch, and au pair. It is sometimes a bit complicated to navigate through these alternatives, but hopefully after watching this video, you will feel more confident about taking the right decisions, and can you focus on your work, knowing that your child will be in good hands. Daycare. Daycare is meant for children from about 10 weeks old up to their 4th birthday. There are lots of variations in daycare, including in terms of with or without a preschool program, the type of contracts they offer, their opening hours, the teaching approach or philosophy they follow, and the age ranges within the groups. You should also check the extra facilities and activities the daycare centers offer, and what additional fees they charge for them. How to choose a daycare? Location. First, you should look at which daycare centers are available in your area. Each municipality has their own web pages with this kind of information. For Amsterdam, for example, you should check out the Schoolwijzer website.
If you're still unsure whether to look for a daycare center close to your home or to your work, you should ask yourself some questions, such as, how will your child get to the facility if you are sick, have to work from another location, or you change jobs or offices?
Childcare close to home usually proves to be more convenient. Since many friendships, also for parents, start in daycare, it is nice if your child goes to the local primary school together with some of their daycare friends. Having friends around often makes it easier to adjust to school. Composition of groups. The maximum group size may be 16 children, but this number is closely related to the ages of the children. To give you an idea, one teacher may take care of 3 children under 1-year-old. While they may have a maximum of 8 children between 3 and 4, and there also needs to be enough indoor and outdoor space available per child. Most daycare facilities work with what are called horizontal groups, which combine children aged 0 to 2 years old and separate groups for 2 to 4 year olds. If this is the case, they often offer a more challenging program for the toddlers to gradually prepare them for primary school. Other daycares have vertical groups for children aged 0 to 4 years old. This means they better represent a family situation, with children of various ages. The older children help the younger ones, and the smaller children naturally learn from the bigger classmates.
Structure of the day. Usually, a daycare day isn't very structured. Especially with babies, the teachers follow the rhythm of the little ones. Before you start, the teachers will invite you for an intake meeting, to learn how your child sleeps and eats at home, and what they like to do when they are awake. The teachers will try their best to match this program. It is very common that a new child first starts with a few hours per day for the first week, so they can gradually get used to their new environment with different faces and sounds.
The teachers eat lunch with all the children together, while sitting around a table. During lunch, they have some group conversations in which everyone may take part. For the rest of the day, the children sing songs and dance, read books, work on some art and crafts projects, play outside, and regularly get some free time to choose their own activities. Some daycares hire specialized teachers, for example for music or yoga, for which you'll have to pay extra. Some make a point of getting children to play outside as much as possible, while others are more focused on children's artistic development. When daycares offer a toddler program, they often gradually introduce some letters and numbers and practice some counting, but all in a playful way. Food. In my experience, some international parents are used to a full hot meal for lunch and are shocked by the sandwiches with salad or soup lunches and small afternoon snacks many Dutch daycare facilities serve. It is important to understand that for many Dutch people, breakfast and dinner are more important than lunch. And dinner is often much earlier in the day compared to, for example, the Mediterranean countries. Most children arrive at daycare in the morning with a full stomach, and their parents usually expect them to have dinner around 6 or 6:30 p.m. These parents are often not too happy if their children eat a lot for lunch and also have afternoon snacks, and then don't touch their dinner at home anymore. On the other hand, parents who aren't used to big breakfasts and who often eat dinner around 8 p.m. or later often complain that their children are hungry after daycare and that they are not being fed enough. For this reason, it's very important to share your habits and expectations in advance, so the teachers can accommodate these as much as possible. Nowadays, daycare centers which have more international population are more likely to serve hot lunches, so maybe this suits you better. You have to pay extra for this service though. Language. The daycare inspectors are very strict on the language spoken at daycare. They require all teachers to speak Dutch to at least upper intermediate level. At most daycare centers, the teachers speak Dutch to the children. There are many children who don't speak Dutch at home, and the teachers are very used to accommodating them. Most teachers can speak English with their parents if preferred, and sometimes also other languages. As many daycare teachers grew up outside of the Netherlands and needed to invest a lot of time and energy into learning Dutch, it is not a given that they also speak good English. You should ask your child's teachers what is the best way to communicate with them. There are a few bilingual daycares, where the teachers speak both Dutch and English with the children. Since the language laws for daycares are very strict, it is extremely difficult to legally establish a bilingual daycare. Since there is a clear need for this, the law will hopefully be changed soon. If you want a fully English-spoken daycare, your best chances are with the nursery department of private international schools, which often starts at age 2 or 3. However, these nurseries are expensive and unfortunately the tax rebate doesn't apply. Inspection. You can find all daycare centers that are officially registered in the National Child Care Register. This also gives the rating of the inspection. Every year, inspectors visit daycare facilities with a very long checklist. They rate the centers based on many items, including their pedagogic approach, staff's relevant diplomas, qualifications, and Dutch language proficiency, but also teacher-child ratio, indoor and outdoor space, sleeping arrangements, the state of the building, hygiene protocols regarding, for example, food, emergency situations, and recognizing child abuse. If the inspectors find some things that are not right, the centers get a chance to make the necessary improvements. If the issues are too severe or not resolved in time, the centers risk getting a fine or even being closed down. So these ratings are very serious. You can find the detailed inspection reports on the website mentioned on this page. They are all in Dutch though. All the things that are okay, in order in Dutch, are marked in dark blue. And the things that are partly not okay, deals niet in orde, in light blue, which makes it easier to get an overall understanding of the situation. Types of contract. Most daycare centers only offer full day contracts, but some allow parents to bring their children for half days. Each daycare decides their own opening hours, which are commonly between 7:30 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. You'll have to pay for the full 11 hours, even if you bring your child later or pick them up earlier. The reason is that the teachers will still be working after your child has left, and also their fixed costs stay the same regardless. Some places offer additional hours before or after the official opening hours for parents who need more time. You will have to pay extra for this service. Some daycares make you choose between a full year contract, which is 52 weeks, or for care during the school weeks only, which is 40 weeks per year, which might be convenient if you have another child who already goes to school. In order to accommodate, for example, divorced parents, some daycare centers also offer every other week contracts. Many mothers and fathers in the Netherlands work part-time, as they wish to combine work with raising their children and value a good work-life balance. As a consequence, many children attend childcare on 1 to 4 fixed days per week. The contract should state how it works if you occasionally want to swap days or change to a different fixed day. So before you sign the contract, make sure that you understand their terms and conditions well. The notice period for termination of the contract or for reducing the number of days per week is usually 1 calendar month. In most situations, the daycare contract automatically finishes on the day of your child's 4th birthday, when they can go to school. That is a different ballgame altogether. I explain how this all works in another Doodly video. Finances. Daycare centers may establish their own hourly fees, and they don't come cheap. Usually they charge between 8 to 11 euros per hour, also depending on the additional facilities and services they offer. If both parents work, or if a single parent works, you should be able to apply for a tax rebate for childcare, known in Dutch as kinderopvangtoeslag. This amount is not only dependent on the income of both parents, or the single parent, but also on how many days and hours of childcare you need per week. Kinderopvangtoeslag is paid on a monthly basis by the Belastingdienst, which is the Dutch Tax and Customs Administration. In a table at the bottom of this page, you can get an idea of how much money you'll get back. The tax return ranges between 33 and 96% of the daycare costs. The higher your household income, the lower your monthly return. The rebate is higher for parents who have two or more children who attend childcare. Please note that by first child, they mean the child who is in childcare for the most hours per week, and not necessarily the oldest child. How to apply? You should apply directly to the daycare center. Most daycares have an online application form on their website. Apart from a few personal details, they will ask you for your desired start date and number of days per week. Be aware of the waiting list that many daycare centers have. Some parents-to-be already apply for childcare before the pregnancy test is dry. There also seems to be a baby boom after the corona lockdowns. If you need a 5-day contract, it could take some time for all necessary days to become available, as you often depend on a few part-time children in the same group leaving. You should apply for several daycare centers at the same time. Once a daycare can offer you a spot, you should cancel your other applications and only sign a contract with one place.
Preschool. Every city has its own policy for preschoolers. Usually preschool starts at age 2, but in some municipalities your child needs to be 2.5. The biggest difference with daycare is that preschool is more structured. At preschool, the children follow a dedicated program. The teachers have been educated as preschool teachers and are specialized in teaching Dutch to children who don't speak Dutch at home. The teachers gradually prepare the pupils for primary school. They follow the same structure of the day as primary school and work with the same themes. The children learn a lot of new vocabulary related to the theme, and they sing songs, read books, make art, dress up, and go on excursion in connection with the theme at hand. Preschool also puts a strong focus on social skills. Fine and gross motor skills, learning through play, sharing, waiting your turn, and playing together as well as independently. Usually the preschool program is offered for 15 or 16 hours per week, spread out over 3 days, but also here every city has its own rules. The same teachers and pupils meet on fixed days, which makes preschool less flexible than daycare, where parents may choose which days suit their schedule. The maximum class size of preschool is 16 children. And there are 2, sometimes 3, fixed teachers per group. Preschools work together with a specific primary school and are sometimes located in the same building. They are run by a different organization, however, and you still have to apply for the primary school according to the policies of your city. In most cases, preschoolers don't get priority for the connected primary school, and you are free to choose a different school if you wish. Finances. If both parents work, or if a single parent works, you may apply for the same tax rebate as the daycare rebate we talked about earlier. To make sure that all children are well prepared for primary school and have had a chance to socialize with other children, the municipality gives subsidies for children whose parents are not eligible for the tax rebate. Like daycare centers, preschools establish their own hourly rates, and the amount you get back also depends on your household income. The preschool will ask you to fill out an additional form. It will help you with the application for the municipal subsidies. How to apply? The preschools are run by various organizations, which normally cover a few neighborhoods in the city. You apply online with the organization and can give your preferences for location. There's usually not much difference between the preschools run by the same organization, so parents commonly choose a location based on proximity and availability. VVE indication. Maybe you've heard about the VVE indication, also known as preschool referral, before. There are a lot of misunderstandings about what it is, and also here the municipalities have made different policies. The main purpose of a VVE indication is to prevent or overcome any delays early in a child's life, and to prepare them well for primary school. At a consultatiebureau, also referred to as GDD or OKC, which is the health clinic for babies and toddlers, they will regularly check your child's speech development, among many other things. If a child around the age of 18 months seems to have developed a language delay in their home language, or languages, the consultatiebureau nurse usually issues a VVE indication. Sometimes they also give this referral to children who grow up in an environment where not much language is used with them, for example when the parents have a lower level of education or are not present very much. parents who already speak more than two languages at home and who are interested in sending their children to Dutch primary school later on often also qualify for this referral. Not speaking Dutch at home is usually not enough reason to get a VV indication, especially when the parents are highly educated and are very involved in the development of their children. What happens once your child has this indication depends a bit on the municipality. If there is a waiting list for preschool, children who have a VV indication usually get priority. In most cities, children with a VV indication get some hours of preschool for free or for a lower fee than the children without. Furthermore, in most cities, preschoolers with a VV indication get priority when applying for the connected primary school. But, as this doesn't always apply, make sure to check well in advance. Gastouder or childminder. An alternative to daycare or preschool is a gastouder, which directly translates as guest parent. A gastouder is a qualified nanny who takes care of your child or children either at your house or at their own home. Depending on the children's ages, they may look after a maximum of 6 at a time, including their own. The gastouder needs to have an official childminder diploma, a first aid certificate, and a declaration of proper behavior from the police, which states that they have never been arrested for any crimes related to children. And they also need to be registered as a gastouder in a municipality's daycare register, which is called the LRK register. The parents and gastouder arrange all practicalities together. Often a gastouder is more flexible than a daycare in terms of minimum hours per day. Sometimes the children are also welcome in the evening or during the weekend, and some gastouders pick up children from school to provide after-school care. For an additional payment, a gastouder may be able to cook dinner or do some grocery shopping. Some children are easily overwhelmed in a big daycare group and fare better with the more homely environment of a gastouder. Because of the smaller number of children present, it is often easier to make special arrangements for food, nap time or activities with the gastouder as well. Since most gastouders have small children themselves, they usually work part-time. You might therefore encounter some challenges if you try and find a gastouder for 5 days per week. In such instances, a combination between a gastouder and daycare or preschool may be a better solution. Gastouder agency. Gastouders need to be officially registered with a gastouder agency. The agency interviews the parents and matches them up with potentially suitable gastouders. The agency also checks whether the gastouder has all the necessary diplomas, registrations and qualifications, and they take care of all the admin, such as the monthly invoices that you submit to the tax office. They also check the house where the care takes place in terms of safety, health and hygiene, and help prepare for the compulsory inspections by the GGD, which is the Municipal Health Service. The agency also regularly offers training and coaching to their gastouders to make sure they stay up to date and keep developing professionally. If a gastouder is sick or wants to quit their job, the agency will try and help you find a new one. This usually takes some time, so if the gastouder calls in sick in the morning, you will have to come up with a solution yourself for the first days. Finances. The gastouder decides on their hourly fee, which is often a bit lower than that of daycare centers. This also depends on how many children they take care of at a time and whether the care takes place at your home or at theirs. Often gastouders also give discounts for multiple children from the same family, which is something a daycare usually doesn't do. Since the gastouder offers a more tailor-made care package, parents usually end up paying less for a gastouder than for daycare, especially if they have two or more children. When a gastouder is officially registered with an agency and has all qualifications and diplomas and has also registered in the LRK register, you may apply for the same tax rebate as for daycare. This only applies when both parents work or if a single parent works, however. You'll have to pay a monthly fee to the agency as well. The fee varies per agency and depends on the number of hours per month you need a gastouder. Au pair. The last childcare solution I would like to discuss is an au pair. It is not very common for Dutch parents to hire an au pair, but it is definitely possible to do this in the Netherlands. That being said, hiring an au pair isn't easy, and there are a lot of rules and regulations you should be aware of. To start with, an au pair may only help with babysitting duties and light household chores for a maximum of 8 hours per day and a maximum of 30 hours per week, so they don't fully cover for full-time working parents. An au pair comes to the Netherlands for a cultural exchange and stays with her host family for a maximum duration of 1 year. They must be between 18 and 31 years of age. You will need a spare bedroom for the au pair to stay in, as well as the financial means to support an extra adult in your household. In addition to room and board, An au pair is entitled to a maximum of 340 euros per month as pocket money, for which you cannot request a tax rebate. Finding a suitable au pair can be a time-consuming process. All au pair applications must formally go through a recognized au pair agency, for which you need to pay intermediary fees as well. The procedure can take up to 3 months, depending on the au pair's nationality and the visa they have to apply for. However, once you have figured this all out, an au pair is probably the most flexible, personal and cheapest form of childcare. Now that you are armed with all this information, I hope you'll be able to make the best choices for your family. If you have any further questions, I welcome you to book a video call through newtonl.com/families. I hope your children have a great time with their childcare providers in the Netherlands. Bye bye!